Dear students, next we are going to see about sliding mesh gearbox. Before that, we should know what is gearbox or what are the functions of gearbox. Gearbox is a mechanical device used for changing the torque via changing the speed. It consists of two or more gears driven by the prime mover, that may be engine or motor. The output speed of the gearbox will be inversely proportional to the gear ratio. Gearbox is broadly classified into different types. In our syllabus, we have three types. One is sliding mesh gearbox, constant mesh gearbox, and synchro mesh gearbox. Now we are going to see about sliding mesh gearbox. So it is the very simplest type of gearbox. Here spur gears are used. The gearbox we taken here for illustration has three forward gears and one reverse gear. Here three gears are attached on the main shaft and four gears attached on the lay shaft. Gear number 6 and gear number 5 can be moved by a shift fork with gear number 3 and gear number 4 on the lay shaft or counter shaft. So this is called sliding mesh gearbox. And we have one separate idler gear on the idling shaft for reverse purpose. Okay, now we will see the position. First one is gears in the neutral. So this is the setup of neutral condition. When the engine is running and the clutch is engaged, the counter shaft is driven by the clutch gear so that the low speed and high speed gears, that is gear number 6, gear number 5, gear number 3 and gear number 4 are not in engaged position, so that no motion is transmitted from clutch to the output shaft. That is the vehicle is in stationary condition. So next, the position of the first gear. Here, the fork lever, that is a gear shift fork lever, will be moved towards direction number 1. So this is the direction number 1. So what happens? So the gear number 5 will get engaged with the gear number 4, so that the power will be transmitted through gear number 1, gear number 2, gear number 4, gear number 5 to the output shaft. If the gear number 1 is rotating in the clockwise direction, gear number 2 will rotate in the anti-clockwise direction, and the same will obtain in the gear number 4, as gear number 2 and gear number 4 both are engaged in the same lay shaft or counter shaft. So this anti-clockwise directional rotation will be transferred into clockwise rotation of gear number 5, so that the output shaft will rotate in the same direction what this shaft rotates, that is clutch shaft rotates. This position, the position will give lowest speed. It is based on the gear trains, the position of the gear trains. Okay, next we will discuss the gear number 2, that is second gear. So that the fork lever, gear shift fork, will be moved in this direction, that is second direction. So that the gear number 5 and the gear number 4 will get disengaged, and gear number 6 and gear 3 gets engaged, so that the power transmitted from the clutch shaft will be in the gear number 1, gear number 2, gear number 3, gear number 6 and output shaft. So this is the speed will be comparatively higher than the first gear. The position of the gear train is entirely based on the position of the gear train. Small gear, big gear, and this gear is comparatively lesser in diameter than gear number 2, and this gear is comparatively bigger than gear number 1, so that more speed can be obtained. Next one is gear number 3, that is third gear. Here the position of the gear number 3 will be obtained by moving the gear shift fork towards the left direction, so that gear number 6 and gear number 1 is directly engaged, so that the power transmitted without engaging with the gears on the any of the gears within the counter shaft. So the power is directly transmitted to the output shaft. So what speed the clutch gear, clutch shaft rotates, the same can be obtained in the output shaft. So the transmission will be in gear number 1, 6, 5 and output. Finally, reverse gear. Here, when the gear shift fork is moved towards the direction R, the sliding gear 5 will be shifted backward to mesh with the reverse idler gear as shown in the figure. In this figure, then the rotation of the input shaft is transmitted in order 1, 2, 7, 8 and 5 to turn the output shaft in the reverse direction. So this is the entire setup of a sliding mesh gearbox. This question will be asked probably in 13 mark question. So if it is asked in 13 mark question, you have to draw the entire positions. For example, if this question is asked in 7 marks or 8 marks, you can draw only this diagram and you can explain first gear, second gear, third gear and reverse gear directly. But if this question is asked in 13 mark question, you have to draw the entire position of the gears. First gear, second gear, third gear and reverse gear. You have to draw everything. This is the setup of sliding mesh gearbox. Thank you.